Today we are making this paneer manchurian recipe. Looks delicious, isn't it? We are making it in restaurant style. It won't take much time to make. So hey foodies, welcome to Cooking Shooking. The texture of paneer will be fantastic, super soft. So let's get cooking. Here I have a 200 gram block of paneer. We will chop it into pieces. I've got around 16 pieces and this looks good. Now let's make it flavorful with a coating which will also protect the softness and the juiciness of the paneer. I've added to a mixing bowl. Next we will use 3 tablespoons of cornstarch. You can also use arrowroot. 3 tablespoons of maida. Half a teaspoon of red chili powder. 1/4 teaspoon of garam masala. You heard me right. For making it restaurant style, we have to add it, half a teaspoon of soya sauce, salt to taste, a little bit of ginger garlic paste. Now we will give it a mix with light hands. Looks good. We will now use water to make a semi-thick coating on the paneer. Don't pour a lot of water at a time, add a little, keep it moving and you will have a semi-thick coating something like this. So the paneer is done in restaurant style, time to fry now. The oil is well heated in high flame, it is very hot. We will drop the paneer and fry for about 2 minutes. This is for making soft manchurian. If you want to make crispy, then you have to fry in medium heat. Just about 2 minutes, the paneer is done, let's take it out. Similarly, I'm going to cook the second batch. We just want to cook the ginger garlic paste and the maida corn flour, that's it. We don't want to cook the paneer much. If they stick together, you can break them something like this and the second batch is also ready. Now let's make the manchurian sauce. Here I have a Chinese kadhai which is also known as a wok. We will heat on high flame. If you don't have this, you can also use a steel kadhai that also gets hot very quickly. This type of Chinese kadhai is very thin. That is the reason it gets hot very quickly, guys. As it is getting hot, I am adding oil, about 1.5 tablespoon from the sides. If you add it from sides, it gets hot quickly and nothing sticks on the sides of the wok. Alright, so the oil is hot, we will add the garlic. Here I have about 2 tablespoons of chopped garlic. Along with that, 1 tablespoon of spring onion whites, which is again chopped fine, and about 1 inch of ginger, which is also chopped fine. We will stir it together, don't let it burn, keep the flame high. Next, we will add capsicum. This is a medium sized capsicum, not full, just 1/4 of that. We will give it a stir as well, because the flame is high, we don't want to let it burn. In total, I've cooked all of these 3 together for hardly a minute. We will quickly add the sauces. Here I have Szechuan chutney, 1 heaped teaspoon, 2 teaspoons of tomato ketchup, and 1 teaspoon of soya sauce. We will mix all of these 3 together and cook for about 30 seconds on high flame. Time to add some salt, about 1/2 a teaspoon of black pepper powder, and a little more of the soya sauce, about 1/2 a teaspoon more. You can also add some seasoning powders or MSG if you want the same restaurant style taste. I've committed not to use for the time. So we will give it a mix. You can see how well the sauces are cooking. The oil has also started to separate. Looks good. Next we will add water. Here I have 1/2 a cup of water. We will give it a stir. As the water is heating quickly, we will make a slurry. Here I have 2 teaspoons of cornstarch. We will mix it with some water to make a slurry. With 2 teaspoons of cornstarch, we are making dry manchurian. The slurry is ready, let's add it a little at a time and we will cook it together. With this, our watery sauce will get saucy. To finish it off, we will also add some spring onion greens and now you can see how saucy the manchurian sauce has become. This is thick as we are making dry manchurian. Time to add the paneer and we will mix it together. Oh wow, look at this. Because of the coating, the paneer is not breaking easily. But look at this guys, looks amazing isn't it? We will turn the flame off and it's time to serve now. Our homemade restaurant style paneer manchurian is ready. You can garnish it with some spring onion greens and enjoy.
So how was the paneer manchurian recipe, guys? If you enjoyed it, click the like button and share it with your friends. If you did not like it, click the dislike button. I hope to see you soon with one more video. That's all for today.